Kiss to Me Kim from Naio Nails. So we've got here the products that we're going to use today. It's quite a simple design because obviously we're going to match this to my lips that we will do in a bit. So I've got my nails that are plain. They were like this. They did have a pretty little bow and some bling bling. These were actually my birthday nails, believe it or not. And I've just filled a few of them, that's all. I couldn't fill obviously the one with the bow on because that would be impossible. So on this hand, we're going to use this as our base. So first of all, I'm going to wipe over using the gel residue wipe off solution so it's all nice and clean, ready for the gel polish application. All nice and clean. The colour that I'm going to use today is called Muddly Puddly. So it's like a brown grey taupe. Is it a taupe?
I'm not a colour catalogue.
I think that that's like a taupe colour. Anyway, you can see it on screen, you know what it looks like. That's the colour that I'm using today. So I'm going to put two coats of this on. Doing it on my own hands because obviously I'm matching this to my own lips. That'd be weird if I was matching it to somebody else's. Maybe we could use your lips one day.
I've got good lips.
You've got good lips. So I'm going to do one coat on all of these. A full cover we're doing. Making sure I'm going right to the cuticle, but I'm not flooding the cuticle. Gonna pop that into the lamp, into the UV lamp for 2 minutes. Not one, but 2 minutes. I'm gonna do the second coat of this beautiful colour. So now they're cured, I'm going to take off the sticky layer with the gel residue wipe off solution. And they'll go slightly matte. They won't be quite as shiny, they're more like a satin finish now. So for the next step, I'm going to use some acrylic paint. So some of the polycolor black. I'm gonna pop that into my palette. So this design will be quite simple. I'd like to say it's simple, but it's very precise. They still have to be really neat and precise. And it's exactly the same as what we're gonna have to do on the lips. Be very neat and precise. I'm going to add a little bit of water to the paint because I want it to flow really easily on the nail. I'm going to use a shorter brush first of all. And this design is all from my head. I've sort of been inspired by clean, sort of geometric flowing patterns, so that's what I'm gonna do. So I'm neatly gonna do a crisp line around the edge of this side. just neatening up this line here and scraping off what I don't want. So painting directly on top of the gel polish. So because this is just paint, it's so easy to just make those mistakes go away. Bye bye mistake, bye bye. Now I don't know if I'm going to be able to do the same kind of thing when it comes to my lips. I won't be able to go bye bye mistake. I'll be like, okay, let's start over again. So on the rest of the nails, we're going to do these random shapes. So I'm always seeing these kind of things on Instagram, these lip nail match things. And I just really wanted to try and see if you can actually do it. And it looks really good without all the Photoshop. Because let me tell you, this lip and nail thing that you see all over Instagram is heavily Photoshopped, believe me. So we're gonna try and create that look on camera without Photoshop. Now I'm going to use the matte top coat. So I want them to be matte because my lips are going to be matte. So I'm going to make sure I seal all of this in. Because when you take the sticky layer off, if you haven't sealed all of that artwork in and you take the sticky layer off, you're going to take the artwork off as well. We don't want that. So make sure you seal right to those edges, especially where you framed the nail as well. So I'm going to pop that into the lamp for 2 minutes now and give that a full cure. I'm going to put 2 coats of the matte top coat on. I'm going to take those out and I'm going to wipe those over with the wipe off solution. So they are wiped off the sticky layer and we've got that finish. So now I'm going to match my lips. The products that I'm going to use for my lips are the Jeffree Star, it's called Posh Spice. And then to do the blank design, I've got a couple of liquid eyeliners. We've got a Rimmel Scandalized one, and we've got an NYX Super Fat Eye Marker. So I'm gonna put this on first. Now this will dry matte. So I'm going to do one side first and then match up the other side, going from my cupid's bow out. Now for the bottom lip, making sure I've got enough product on the applicator to create a nice crisp line. And making sure I cover all of my lip in this gorgeous colour. So I'm going to use this Precision one. I'm calling it Precision one. Oh, it is called the Precision Micro Eyeliner because I need it to be precise. Every time that nib runs dry, I'm just going to shake it down in the lid. Because you can see if you don't do it with the lid, it will go everywhere. I want this to be really black. So granted, you do need a steady hand for this. But I'm resting my hand on my face while I do it, so I can stay quite steady. With any of the excess that is on this nib here, on this plastic bit, I'm just scraping it on the lid so I can keep reusing that. I'm just going to map out these little lines so I know what the spacing's right, and I can carry on with the actual lines of the pattern. Let's see how pigmented the Jeffree Star stuff is, see if it covers that mark. Wow. I'm going to use a fat liner now. I'm trying to not touch it. So when I'm doing larger sections, I'm using the larger one, the big fat eye marker, and then for the little ones I'm using the Scandalized Precision. It's okay to put these eyeliners on your lips. The only thing is, if you wanted to wear this all day or of an evening, if you're that crazy, then you would need to use a waterproof one. For obvious reasons, because else you cannot drink, you cannot touch your lips, you can't lick your lips, you can't do anything like that. So you would need to use, possibly you could use something like the Double Wear Estee Lauder one, which is just as good. This is waterproof. I might even use that one now, actually. For the hell of it, show you a different one. I am getting covered in black off that other one because I keep shaking it down. Whereas this one, you dip it in, you keep dip it, reloading it like you would a mascara. I do prefer this. I'm just going over a few parts with it. So there you are, I've done my full lips now. Let's have a look, if we can see what it looks like for one of those nice Instagram pictures. I've got good lips. I didn't used to. They just sort of grew on me. They just grew. My lips just grew overnight with the help of Dr. David.